Hi everybody, my name is Maria. I studied this course about sustainable development with all the things I learned at university, books I read, conclusions and maybe some proposals, because I consider that sharing knowledge is one of the best ways to achieve a better world for us. So, let's get started. Today we're going to talk about the Deep Sea model, but what is a model? A model is a simplified abstraction of a system. To obtain the behavior of this system, and maybe you can introduce some inputs to obtain a better response to control it. And how a system is simplified? Well, we have three aspects to simplify a system. The first one is reducing the dimensionality of the system. For example, you can have two axes, x, y, and that is enough to predict or to have the behavior of the system. The second one is eliminating the less important processes that affect the system. And the third one is introducing simplified definitions to describe the system. And we have 8 key elements to model. Understand the problem, evaluate the models that already exist, create a conceptual model, think like the user, simplify the conceptual model, ensure the user satisfaction with a created model, design simulations, and finally, knowledge gained. So with this introduction, we can talk about the Deep Sea model. Deep Sea model is useful to understand the global problem, how this problem can affect the environment, and which responses could be proposed. We have 5 stages for the Deep Sea model. D for driving forces, P for pressures, S for states, I for impacts, and R for responses. I'm going to explain you each stage with a question. For driving forces, which activity generates the problem? For pressures, how do these activities affect? For states, how does the environment change? For impacts, what are the impacts of the changing state? And finally, for responses, how do we respond for the impacts? And in this part of responses, we can have 4 types to respond to each part of the Deep Sea model, to each stage. First, structural responses, then institutional responses, and nature-based responses, which are solutions based on nature. And, well, the last one is an hybrid that could be the combination of 2 or 3 of them. I'm going to give you an example to explain the Deep Sea model. To start doing the Deep Sea model, we need a problem to solve, to model, to obtain the behavior. And in this case, is a waste of organic waste. As a driving force, we have to make the question, which activity generates the waste of organic waste? Well, in this case, we are going to focus in one driving force, which is growing population. Then we have a pressure. How do growing population or consumption affect? The answer is for waste production. Then we have the state. How does the environment change with waste production? Well, we can notice some changes in water quality or human health. And then we have impacts. What are the impacts of the changing state? Well, if we have a worse water quality and we have maybe some problems with human health, the impact could be damage to human health. And for these impacts, for these states, for this pressure, for this driving force, we can achieve responses. For driving forces, we could have a response that could be institutional, which is promote education about organic wastes. In other words, conscientization. Then we have a response for pressures that could be a structural response with biodigesters. And then we have a response for the impact that in this case is an hybrid because it's a mix of a structural and nature-based that is used compost as fertilizer. If we have a response for impacts, we are making a response for a short period of time. But if we focus in solve the driving problem, the growing population, if we have a response for driving forces, we are achieving a response for a long period of time. So, in this case, to achieve a response for a long period of time, that is, the conscientization, it's a little bit difficult to achieve it, because it's not possible to achieve the best world with a stable population, with people that know and keep in mind the future generations, the environment. I think it's a little bit difficult to achieve that each person think about it. So in this case, I choose the structural response, which is a response for pressures and is to construct the biodigesters to reduce the amount of organic wastes. But this model, the DeepSeer model, has some limitations, and I'm going to explain you. First of all, this model don't have a clear cause-effect relationship. We can notice a lack of use of dynamic indicators. We can notice a weak communication between researchers and public. And we can find a clear boundary between state and impact. And you can find more limitations, and I'm going to leave in the below part a journal which Resumer has an abstract about the limitations of the DeepSeer model and how can we improve it. Maybe we can do some modifications to have a better DeepSeer model. So I hope you find this video interesting. If you think this video can help another person, please share it. If you have a question, please leave a comment in the below part and I will be happy to have a conversation with you. So see you soon and bye!